Good morning, good morning, good morning, you guys. It's your girl, the real true divine feminine here, y'all. Now listen, it's 7 something in the morning. It's too early for this foolishness, but I gotta come and tell y'all this right here. So listen, a man is getting ready to come tell you how he been loving you for all this time, and he's sorry for hurting you. The man that messed with your cousin, the cousin don't mean anything to him. She was just a little fling, and rise. This man is hilarious. You hear me? When I tell you hilarious, he is hilarious. Because he's going to come and tell you all these sweet nothings. He's going to come and tell you what the cousin them been trying to say. Everybody who played a part with keeping you and him apart or whatever. But listen, he ain't going to say how they stole money from you. He ain't going to say that they plotted against you to steal money from you. He ain't going to say all the rest of that. But he going to come and tell you. Matter of fact, he trying to bump into you somewhere. Trying to make like it's a coincidence that you there. He's stalking you so hard about what you putting up on your page, blase, blase, blase. He doing all this because he want to bump into you so bad. When he going to bump into you, he going to act like it's a coincidence. I haven't seen you in years. You know, I've always loved you. You always been on my mind. I've been thinking about you. Hey, you know, can we talk? Can we sit right here and talk or whatever? And you're going to be the flunky and talk to him. And he going to be like, you know, I got a baby with your cousin. I didn't mean to have a baby with your cousin. Sit your garbage ass down. He meant everything he did. You heard me? That man's garbage. Point blank and period. Do not fall for his tricks. Do not fall for his train. He trying to make you feel, he know you an empath. He trying to make you feel sympathy for him. He trying to get back in your energy. He trying to do all the rest of this. Girl, let that clown go ahead. Listen, whoever you is, you got somebody in your life right now that loves you. You heard me? Not only are they telling you they love you, they showing that you love. They there for you every step of the way. You heard me? You, this person used to hold weight in your heart. You used to want to be with this person. You used to love this person. But that's when you was a little girl. You heard me? You're not a little girl anymore. You're a grown woman. Listen, this person gonna try to come in or whatever. Then the crazy part about it is, listen, so once he find out that you, wherever you at, where he gonna run into you or whatever, and you gonna share your location where you back living at or whatever, your cousin, the one who slept with your person, is gonna try to come and talk to you. Listen, I'm here to tell you right here, right now. No, I'm not about to tell you that. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to me on this part right here, what I'm about to say. Y'all, God, please forgive me. You know what? Never mind. Don't even entertain none of that. Y'all better than me. Listen, I ain't going to sit here and lie to y'all better than me. Because once I don't fool with somebody, I don't care. Your mama died, your auntie died. I don't care who died. I don't care about you. That's a dead game mafia. Once I don't care about you or what you got going on, you are no longer my concern. And neither is none of your people. Point blank, period. But you're going to sit up here. You're going to hold this conversation with this person. You're going to give this man a hug. I seen the whole thing. I don't know if y'all at Walmart, Costco's. This might be Aldi, whatever that store called. I don't know. It's at a grocery store. But you're going to see this bastard. And he is going to come and try to hug on you, try to tell you this and try to tell you that and tell you you look nice and all the rest of that. It's garbage ass. That's what he is, garbage ass. It's garbage ass down. You hear me? And if you go back and lay with the goddamn garbage ass man, you're going to be a dumpster with your trashy ass too. So you don't even need to do that. Don't go back and entertain these people. Don't become no trash. You hear me? You have elevated. You hear me? God has elevated you. You have got paid. You have overcome all your pain, all your suffering. God has been good to you for you to go back and spend a bit on somebody. I don't care who this person is. I don't care if it was written for you and this person to be together. When you wanted to be with this person didn't want to be with you. And I don't care what y'all say in these comment sections. You can agree to disagree. It is what it is and it ain't what it ain't. That is so nasty. To mess with somebody who your cousin has messed with. That is so nasty and trifling. Now, don't keep it twisted because it goes on in my own family. They got babies for their brothers and cousins and all the rest. They just nasty. But I'm just saying, why would you want to be a part of that? Don't be a part of nothing like that. Let your cousin have him and their little baby. And all the rest of that, let them go ahead about their business. You don't care about nothing what they got going on because I'm telling you. Don't mess up what God has sent you. God has sent you somebody, and only you know if this message is for you. God has sent you a man
who loves you. Excuse me.
Who loves you for you and willing and want to be with you by all means necessary. The past is trying to hold on to you. Let me tell you something. See, this man always knew that you would be something. This man always knew that you would be big. This man always knew that you was a star. This man always, always, always knew that you was a queen. You heard me? He always knew this. You see, but he was unsure of himself. He was sure of you, but unsure of himself. So what he did was he allowed other people to get in his head about you. Even though he knew the things wasn't true, his flesh was weak. So that's why he entertained the things people were saying about you. And that's how your cousin was able to manipulate him to get in the bed with them and create a little baby. Oh, I almost said something, Lord Jesus. I almost said it out. It almost slipped out, Lord God. And now this person wants to come back and try to talk and communicate with you. No, that don't go like that. That's crazy to me. That is insane to me. Why, under what circumstances would I want to deal with anybody who slept with my cousin or anything? Then the crazy thing about this, y'all, listen. The cousin is younger than you, but the cousin is a 304. You heard me? I'm talking about ran through. She got more cars ran through it than Broad Street Ambassador, Jewel. She got more cars ran through her than, I don't know, she been around the block, up the block, doing all the rest of this. So not only did this person lie and say like you were on drugs and different, when you never did any of that before. But this person is all on drugs. This person told this man that they work, they do this and that. But what this person do is they sell their body. That's what they considered working, as sell their body. But they try to say that about you. But if that was true, this person that been watching you, been loving you for the longest, they couldn't hit. You heard me? So if you was giving your body away so freely, that mean that person would have been able to hit, and that person couldn't hit. You understand what I'm saying? And this person being infatuated with you, every time you turn him down, it's like he get a hard on or something. Every time you turn him down, every time you used to reject them or whatever, then y'all lost contact or whatever, where he didn't know how to get in touch with you, or you changed your number, however the situation would be. But he still had been watching you behind the scenes. And this person, he wants to come in and he's going to try to offer you all the rest of this stuff. Let me tell you something. A man that's really for you will not buy you. He will not buy you whatsoever. To be honest with you, a man that's really for you will pray broke till the end of time to see what will you do. You heard me? If he can't buy you, say you need something and he can't buy it for you, he'll see. He got a pocket full of money, but he'll see what you'll do or how you react. You heard me? Without getting it. He'll see that. But a person that just wants you, he gonna try to buy you. He gonna try to buy everything for you. He gonna try to do this and he gonna try to do that and do that. He's gonna try to impress you with his money. You understand what I'm saying? Now listen. I'm not saying having money is bad. It is not bad, okay? But listen, why would you want a man to provide for you what you cannot provide for yourself? I'm just saying. I'm just a messenger. Why would you want that? You heard me? Because that way that man is controlling you. He's controlling you with his money. Well, hell, to be honest with you, he trying to buy you something with your own money. So he want to control you with your own money. But that's not here or there. That's on your body. My thing is right here. I, for the like of me, I don't even know why, because you're going to sit up here and you're going to entertain this man. When I tell you you're going to entertain him, you're going to sit up here and you're going to entertain this man with conversation, hugs, giving him your number. You're going to fall right into his trap. Baby, I'm here to tell you right here, self-love is always the best love. Love yourself. Love yourself enough to when you see somebody you used to want so bad, they no longer affect you. When somebody who used to hold weight in your heart and they cross you no longer affects you. You have to learn this, baby. Men study women. They play on a man can smell a weak woman a mile away, and he plays on her vulnerability. See, but when your vibration up, when you love yourself enough, when you know who you is, when you in your power, they can't come feed you nothing and hit you with no okie doke. But see, when you ain't in your power and you making out here making these emotional and rational decisions, the men hit you with that okie doke. They play games. You heard me? You want to know, you let my woman keep it a buck with you and tell you why he went with your cousin. He went with your cousin because guess what? He can mess with all kind of other people. He went with your cousin because she was vulnerable. She was weak. See, he knew you were strong. He knew you was going to be somebody. He knew that thing wasn't going to be nobody but the sewer rat that they is. He knew that. He knew that. He didn't want to believe it. You know why? Because here you was. You was dressing probably in your little Walmart. And here she was. Nails done. Toes done, hair done, face full of makeup. Take that makeup off, it's bumpy. Look like a hill, like you're going up a hill. She was all dressed down from her head to the toe and all the rest of this stuff. And here you might have just had some sweats on, hair pulled back in a big old t-shirt like you be. And that's not what he wanted, you heard me? So she was able to catch his eyes, lust of the flesh, you heard me? And then they slept together. And guess what? She done a lot of stuff to him that he knew you wouldn't even never think about doing. So my thing is to you, after you know all this, why would you still want to have a conversation with this person? Why would you still want to be in contact with this person, be friends with this person or anything? That tells a lot about you. To actually still want to entertain a man that had a baby with your cousin. A man that talked down on you underneath your clothes. You heard me? This man talked down on you underneath your clothes. He prejudged you about what you wore, what you have, even though his higher self was telling him that you was going to be somebody. That you were the star. You were the queen. He went against that for his lower self. Why would you want to entertain somebody like that? I'm just trying to understand why. You know, and the last thing that I want to say, I keep telling y'all, family is not what you come from. Family is what you create. One thing on these, my whole years of this earth that I've been on here, is that family will be so jealous of you no matter what you don't have. Some of them will be jealous because you can have a baby when you want to. Some of them could be jealous because you get a lot of attention. Some of them could be jealous because you're pretty and they got to put all this stuff on just to get attention. See, what I learned is the main ones that be talking about you behind your back, telling this person that tell a person, is the same people that's jealous and intimidated by you and wish they can be you. Your cousin wanted to be you so bad, but your cousin can't stand on side of you. Your cousin made fun of your look, said you was this, said you was shaped this way, you was shaped that way. But guess what? Your looks, your weight, whole weight in that nigga heart. And they don't like it. You heard me? They don't like it. She don't like it because she had to do all kind of tricks and trades. And this man still love you. This man still wants you. After all she did, they said, this man still wants you. This man still love you. This man still want to be there for you. And guess what? She's still looking stupid like she did before. I don't know who this message is for. You heard me? I don't know who this message is for. But what I will tell you is, baby, adjust your crown. Adjust your crown so you don't have to spend the being in an entertaining a clown, point blank and period. It's your girl, the Real True Divine Feminine. Please like, share, and subscribe. Peace.